Welcome aboard for another video.
Thanks, Conductor Keith.
Okay, so the purpose of this video is dogs. Well, not just dogs, but cats too. Not just cats either, but animals in general, and how they make your layout come to life, right?
So on this layout, there are 10 dogs. And it's interesting because people watching my videos, sometimes through Facebook or elsewhere, or even on YouTube, will comment on the animals and how they make things come alive. Well, they also comment on the people. Now, people make my layout come alive. Now, this little dog that's playing with Jack there is not from the neighborhood, but comes over to play. This big dog belongs to Dave. And there's the dog's bowls and food. This little dog belongs to the Rousel family. This sheepdog obviously does its work for the gnomes. And we're all familiar with the friar's dog. The friar's loyal dog that accompanies him everywhere. And here's the black dog that for years has been hanging around my stations. And these two young women there have got a little tiny dog. And here's Henry and Marge's dog, playing with a little puppy that belongs to Edna and Josiah, but hangs around with Dave quite a lot. And finally, there's the little Boston Terrier that hangs around inside the locomotive. Yes, but you say these are not the only animals, and well, that's true. There are some on here that I've not mentioned in my videos, just to see if anybody notices. Well, these three horses are obvious. The two cows are obvious. The various pigs are obvious. The moose is obvious. And the bear is very obvious. We have our dandy horse rider and horse. We have the playful fawn and its mother. And of course we have the friar's pony. But what's not so obvious is the little raccoon gunning for the garbage. And the beaver eyeing up that pond. And the restaurant staff better be careful. The health inspector wouldn't want to see that hanging around. And here at Felix's pond, a little turtle. And of course there's cats. Well, you know, there's cats everywhere. Here's a little cat on the front step of the friary. Here's a little cat that hangs around Steve. Steve calls a couple of the neighborhood cats his girlfriends. The gnomes are very anxious to keep mice away, so they have a nice cat here too. And up here, we have a nice little cat too, a hairless cat. My latest little dogs and cats came from Michael's craft store. I think you'll agree that animals make the thing come right to life. So why don't we take a few shots of the train operating? Because after all, this is a channel about large-scale trains, mostly steam. I think maybe I'll even get out a steam engine. But for now, let's have a look at the electric locomotive and passenger train. So now it's time to give the dogs a ride on the train. The people have just ridden around on the passenger cars.
And the locomotive guest of honor today is our Dorothy, which is a regular lumberjack. This dog is not on the train because it's still working. And the Boston Terrier, because that doggy's always in trains anyway.
Lord Michael is driving today, and we have a guest in the cab of the locomotive. It's Michael from Michael Franklin's layout. He's here for a visit, and he's having a ride along as well. Well, the friar is here at his favorite train watching place, and naturally he's a Franciscan, because Saint Francis was a great lover of animals. And the friar hopes that you like this video. Click like, subscribe, comment. We love comments, but most importantly, share this video so we can help encourage our hobby. Oh, Henry, isn't it awfully nice they're giving the dogs a ride?
It is indeed, yes. Yes, it is indeed. One might say the place has gone to the dogs.
Henry, you're such a wag.
Yes, well, that's why you married me.
Well, the owners of the dogs don't seem very concerned. They just know they're having a good time. Well, that was fun. What did you think? We didn't offer the cats a ride on the train, did we? No, because they wouldn't sit still, would they? As a dog lover, Lord Michael is pleased.